So this was the said purchase that I mentioned in the other video. This is the Canon M50. This is the kit lens version. Comes with a 15-45mm kit lens, which is absolutely spot on, really, I think, as the entry level. So not too obtrusive either. You know, it is a super small little camera, half the size of a normal Canon, like 90D or DSLR of that range. So this is the smaller, sort of smaller framed mirrorless camera. So a lot of tech still in this little camera that you would get in some of the high end two to probably £5,000 cameras. So there's a lot of trickle down tech that has gone into this, which is why it swayed me into purchasing this. You know, for 600, I think since 650, I bought this, £650. You can't argue when you've got trickle down tech from some of the great big super duper mirrorless cameras that Canon have just brought out. What's the deal? You know, why wouldn't you go for it? For that money, absolutely perfect. Absolutely chuffed to bits that I bought it. It's got some great stuff on it, which we'll look into next. Some of the specs of this camera. So you can do 1080p and 4K in this video, formats on this camera. I just stick with 1080. It's quite nice and simplistic. Like I said, you can do 4K on this, but as everyone's noticed, it has got this major crop. Your 1080's here, 4K goes to here. So it has a massive crop on the actual image that you're looking at through either the digital viewfinder, which is great, the image on the LCD screen, or actually when you put it into your production software, so Final Cut, Premiere, anything like that. So people do notice it, and I you know, my arms aren't super long, and I can't hold the camera even further away than arm's length. So I think for me, 1080p, it just seems to work. It's nice and simplistic, and you keep the auto focus and auto tracking on 1080p. If you go to 4K, you lose auto focus and tracking, so it's very much a kind of dial in with what you have to do, very much a manual mode. The kit lens now on that, as you can probably see, so not too bulky. You know, this isn't a full frame size camera, which is why I liked it. Initially I bought this because I wanted to put a GorillaPod on the bottom, a Rode mic probably sort of on the top. It's got this hot shoe on it, but I do like this little feature here. It's got a lock for the zoom on it, so if you flick that forward and then start to twist, it unlocks, and as you can see, it unlocks it from the body of the lens, so you can actually start using the camera. Beautiful. I mean, that's a great setup. You know, you're vlogging, doing whatever you want to be doing with this camera. So if I flip that round, hello, perfect. So, you know, you've got a great setup there already. Got your mic on there, preference, whatever you want to do. And there you go. You can actually see what you're shooting perfectly. You can see if your lighting's okay, see if you, the subject's okay, or even any objects or products that you want to be showing. So really great setup. Obviously you can flip that background, close it to protect it. It's got like this sort of vinyl-y kind of cover over it, or even just flip it back into the camera and use it as a normal sort of LCD. So super versatile, really great little camera. I'm loving it so far. I have been trying out some of the manual modes in it as well to see how I get on. Auto's great, but I have found out in some environments I went to, I've been to a National Trust lately, went for a walk with the kids, the family. So auto settings, it did seem to darken some of the images of the kids and some of the environment around it. So I have looked into a few bits and tried the manual mode, and you can actually get some really fantastic results, much better than the autofocus mode. So play around with it. I did intend to buy this as it is a smaller framed camera, purely so I could fit it in my bike bag. I bought a little bag on the front, which we'll look at in another video, hoping to have that on a GorillaPod and then pop that in the front of the handlebar bag when I'm not using it. Unfortunately, the bag, when it turned up, I would have rather it been a little bit bigger. It was a little bit small, and I thought, with a mic on the top and a GorillaPod on the bottom, it's still not a huge setup, but it's big enough where it will be in the way. I think the iPhone's still a great, you know, sort of almost like that GoPro go-to good video camera for out on the road. So that's what I just stick to. Canon camera in here, almost like a studio-y setup. That's where this will be. A tripod, I've got a tripod for it. Cheapest chips off of Amazon, but it does the purpose. You know, it works really, really well. So got that already. I'm gonna look at a microphone as the next purchase for it. But great, so I'm gonna stick with the iPhone for out and about shooting. And the Canon for indoors. 100% really, really recommend it to anyone who is thinking of starting a channel or just an entry level photographer. Right, so that pretty much concludes the sort of roundup of the Canon M50. I must admit, I think I actually surprised myself with the comparison of the 4K and 1080. Really, really impressive actually. So I think I actually impressed myself more than I was expecting to. Yes, the crop's quite dramatic, but footage-wise and tracking and focus-wise, on the example, I was surprised. It did seem half decent. So you never know. Future content may very well make a push to 4K. As I said, I want to use the iPhone for outdoors, Canon for indoors. Both absolutely perfect 4K, really. So yeah, we might do a 4K special, let's see. Okay, so hope you enjoy the video. It's just a very loose unboxing slash review, just to show you, basically, just I'm excited, I got some new gear, whee! So that is the new Canon. So, you know, super excited, and we're gonna use a bit more of that, that's for sure. So take care, guys, and see you in the next one.